for the body of Christ to be united. Hallelujah. Specifically for the church. That is called apostolic faith mission. God said to me, go and teach my people to stand on prayer. For the enemy is just trying to cause confusion. And the impact that is trying to cause, it will actually affect the body of Christ. To a certain extent. And we can't talk about the nation without talking about the church. But if it affects the body of Christ, it will affect even you know the nation at large. Because you see, now the church is the one that is teaching people ethics. Good character. Am I talking to you? So it's a source of concern, because this transition that is taking place, am I talking to you? It might leave some wanting. It might cause some to backslide. It might cause even some are so popular to go back into the world, taking drugs, humanizing, and so forth. So this church is so impactful. This church has been so dynamic against the kingdom of darkness. So there is an infiltration that the enemy has used, trying to destroy it. Now God said to me, encourage your brethren in Christ to stand in this test of time. Whatever you are facing today, it is the test of time. And this test of time, it will push others to take wrong decisions. Because according to the knowledge that I have received, if this plan is successful in this area, if you plant like a seed in Africa, it does not mean that it will be successful in UK. So some of the people, they will prosper under AFM. They don't need to break and to go out. Am I talking to you? But I see a lot of people popping out like popcorns. I see some of them ending up being called apostles, prophets,
pastors, evangelists,
out of frustrations. Yes, some they are called by God to start from there. But I see the majority who are not called to go out, but out of frustration, trying to start something. Am I talking to you? If you have heard, there is what you call Azusa Street, whereby people that were healed in the street, things could happen. God wants his spirit to move within the parameter of that church. He doesn't want the spirit to be hindered. So my brothers in the Lord, I'm standing with you in prayer. The Bible says, if the kingdom is divided, it cannot stand. The church leaders needs to put aside their differences, and they need to go and hear what the Lord is saying. This is the time whereby this church must enter to the mountain in prayer. God said to me, go and encourage my people not to fight each other physically, because the more people that will be fighting each other physically, they are hindering the movement of the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They are grieving the Holy Spirit. The Lord says to me, go and encourage these people to continue moving with the anointing of
Azusa.
Because it was like a relay, the stick has been given to them. They need to catch up the Spirit, the Spirit of revival.
Speed zero and
it must not be limited.
I find it a
because God, he had given them wisdom to decentralize the assemblies.
And
the Spirit of God must begin to move in those assemblies. But I saw some infiltration of carnal men. When I talk about carnality, I'm talking about the works of the flesh. Now when the it now is at the back. When the cross that we see, when it is at the back, instead of being at the front, people will be limited in winning of souls.